The vines of Canaiolo grow down the hill where the sands left by the Ligurian Sea are more pure, calcareous, and the rest of the shells of marine sediments are disintegrated. The grapes of Canaiolo have the body of a red and the finesse of a white. They are a perfect transgender message for a true rosé, neither red nor white. Vinification. We like to get the free-run juice of this grape for the fermentation in stainless steel. We like it to be bottled young and the leaves still fresh, full of the carbon dioxide. We have two rosé, the young rosé for the toast, the slightly older but very fresh rosé for the lunch. We begin for the toast. We begin to toast.
There we are.
Yeah, we have to toast with a champagne flute because this is our champagne. Champagne of Montenegro to make us all very, very happy. And alive, because remember, most important thing is to be alive. So, toast to all of us! For our appetizers, here we have, it's not caviar, because we are not rich enough for caviar, as our champagne is not so expensive, but we can be happy. The Italian schiacciata, here, the bread with olive oil and salt, and we have the fried bread that we love as appetizers. Then, you know, we are in carnival. Here, come here. This is what we called lies, bugie. And then here is the fried bread and fried all kinds of stuff, but we are always having fried food for carnival. Okay, now that is our breakfast, our appetizer. We go for lunch. Appetizers, the fresh for toast. Now for food, we need a more quiet rosé. It's always very fresh, delightful rosé, but it's more settled for a good food. A perfect lunch with a nice rosé, slightly settled, always fragrant, always young, but slightly more settled for food. And this we have octopus with shrimps. Fantastic, together. It's a perfect pairing. Enjoy. For a big dinner, you can have a toast with a rosé, a first light fish with an older rosé, and with a young rosé, you can have your cake